After the disastrous attempt with the R1200C to capture the American cruiser market, it took BMW Motorrad almost 15 years to dip their toes into the cruiser market again with the R18. This time, BMW was adamant about not making the same mistake as they did with the R1200C, which was to deliver a half-baked product that looked hideous. The initial concept of the R18 were showcased at major international motorcycle shows and generated a lot of buzz due to the bike's impressive style and scale. But at the same time, a lot of people did raise some concerns regarding the necessity of such a motorcycle in BMW's lineup. But despite these concerns, BMW's executives gave the green light for the R18's production. The time and money that BMW put into the marketing of the R18 suggested that the people behind this project were confident in its potential success. But now, it seems that they were better off putting all those resources somewhere else, like developing a proper, affordable version of the mighty 1250 GS. That's because, like its predecessor, the R18 is also headed towards failure. It's not because R18 is a terrible motorcycle, but because there were some major mistakes that BMW made while developing the R18. And let's see what are those mistakes. The first one is the motorcycle itself. The R18 is a big cruiser, and the market for big cruiser is primarily concentrated in the United States, and the heavyweight cruiser category is experiencing a significant decline in sales in the United States for the past few years. The segment leader Harley-Davidson has been seeing declining sales year after year. The younger riders just don't want these kinds of motorcycles anymore. They are more interested in lighter, affordable, and fun motorcycles. To make matters even worse, the baby boomer population, who were the major customers of the heavyweight cruisers, is getting to an age where managing such big motorcycles is becoming a painful task. As a result, BMW faces a limited market segment for selling the R18, which is rapidly shrinking. While in the other regions, such as Europe and Australia, they only have niche appeal and sells in small quantities. Therefore, it is obvious that the R18 doesn't have much of a global appeal. More crucially, in larger developing markets such as India and China, where a motorcycle like this considered as heavy motorcycle, the R18 is just unfeasible. The second mistake is the BMW's misjudgment of the customers. The cruiser rider tend to adhere to a certain orthodoxy and don't want to stand out, and BMW's unique boxer engine design is most likely a downer for them. The US cruiser market has been dominated by air-cooled V-twin motorcycles for the last 4 decades, with most buyers unwilling to consider other options. Even when the Japanese manufacturers tried to enter the cruiser market with the parallel twins and four-cylinder engines, they had little to no success until they started building V-twins. However, even when they do end up making an air-cooled V-twin cruiser, it unfortunately ends up as an imitation of the Harley-Davidson styling, again pushing the stubborn cruiser buyer towards Harley-Davidson. And that brings us to the third and the final mistake, the lack of identity. In the pursuit of building the perfect cruiser, the R18 became more of a Harley than a BMW. Yes, the R18 does have some traditional BMW elements like the exposed drive shaft, a massive boxer twin, etc. But unfortunately, that's not enough. If it wasn't for the boxer engine, the R18 can be easily mistaken for a soft-tailed slim from Harley. And the boxer twin, the engine that separates the R18 from the rest, is not doing this motorcycle any good. While the R18's boxer twin does offer a good amount of torque, that thing is heavy. 113 kilograms or 250 pounds to be specific. That's around one-third of the R18's total mass of 345 kg or 761 pounds, which again is enormous. Since it's not even liquid cooled, there's no reason for this engine to be that heavy, unless they are trying way too hard to be a German Harley. In the R18, this 1802cc air-cooled boxer twin does not have any benefits associated with BMW's air-cooled boxer engines from the past. It's not lightweight, nor is easy to handle. BMW claims that the R18 was inspired by their R5 vintage motorcycle. But somewhere along the development of the R18, I think BMW kinda lost its way. What do you guys think? Am I right or wrong? Leave your thoughts in the comment section down below. And as always, if you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Or if you loved it, please consider subscribing to the channel. See you guys next time. Ride safe.